Namaskar. Today in this class, we will discuss the interfacing of 8255 with microprocessor 8085 and then with microprocessor 8086 in IO mapped IO as well as in memory mapped IO. So to start with, to interface any device, any chip with any other microprocessor, we must know the pin configuration of a device, of a chip. Unless and until we know the pin configuration, we cannot interface, right? So first of all, if we talk about 8255, first we will discuss about interfacing of 8255 with 8085. So suppose this is my 8255. Pin configuration की अगर इसकी बात करें, it has three ports, the IO port, the port A, the port B, इसको यहाँ लिखने के बजाय ये कहिए, port A, port B, and this is your port C, right? तो 8 8 8 24 पिन्स तो ये हो गए तीन पोर्ट्स की. यहां पर दिस इज द साइट वेयर यू विल इंटरफेस योर आईओ डिवाइसेस. यहां पर आईओ डिवाइसेस होंगे, ठीक है? कोई भी आईओ डिवाइस हो सकती है, स्टेपर मोटर हो सकती है, एडीसी हो सकती है, डीएसी हो सकती है, कोई डिस्प्ले हो सकता है, 7 सेगमेंट डिस्प्ले हो सकता है, कोई कीबोर्ड हो सकता है, राइट? दे ऑल विल बी कनेक्टेड हियर. On this side, we are having the data bus D0 to D7. Then we have A0. Then we have RD bar and WR bar, and then finally we have reset and we have chip select signal. These are the signals which are to be connected to the microprocessor side, right? इनके काउंटरपार्ट पिंस जो 8086 या 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर में है, वे कौन से होंगे? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, अगर मैं बात करूं 8085 की, तो ये 8085 में ये हमारी एक लैच आईसी होती है, लैच अनेबल सिग्नल होता है. दिस लैच अनेबल सिग्नल इज अनेबल्ड बाय एएलई, राइट? और यहां पर ये हमारी एड्रेस और डाटा बस इसके साथ मल्टीप्लेक्स्ड होती है, एंड हियर ये हमारी डाटा बस होती है, राइट? सो दीज डाटा एंड हियर ये हमारी यू कैन से एड्रेस बस होती है. कौन सी? A0 to A7. इट इज और लैच आईसी 8282, राइट? देन वी हैव ओवर कंट्रोल सिग्नल्स, दैट इज आरडी बार, डब्ल्यूआर बार, आईओ बार, आईओ ऑब्लिक एम बार, एंड हियर देयर these three signal goes to a decoder, 3:8 decoder, 3:8 decoder, and from this decoder there comes four outputs, that is IOR bar, IOW bar, MEM bar, and MEMWR bar, So these are the four control signals which are generated from here, right? Then in 8085 there is an output signal which is known as reset out. Reset out. So now we will connect these signals to 8255. These demultiplexed data bus is connected to the data bus of 8255. Right? Then out of these 8, two of the signals, they are connected as A1 and A0 from here to this A1 and A0 address lines of 8255. And depending on whether we are interfacing in IO mapped IO or memory mapped IO, two of the control signal from here, they will be connected to the read and write control signal to 8255. That is, if we assume that it is in IO mapped IO, IO mapped IO के तहत हम इंटरफेस कर रहे हैं, तो IO R bar will be connected to the RD bar and IO W bar will be connected to the WR bar of 8255. This reset out will be connected to the reset of this 8255. Right? Now, IO ports in IO mapped IO, they will have 8-bit address. They will have 8-bit address. Now these 8-bit addresses, out of the 8-bit, these are the 8-bit address, and out of the 8-bit address, two are connected here, and the rest of the these signals, they are used to enable this chip, or they are to be connected to chip select signal. So you can see, we can connect these two signals, these signals to this, and here we can apply these six signals, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2. And on the basis of this, suppose I connect them like this one. Then, if it is A7 and this is A2, then a combination that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 will enable this chip, and hence the 8255 will start working. And now, along with these 6 bits, the 2 bits, that is A1 and A0, the 2-bit A1 and A0, the different combination of these will give rise the different port addresses. That means it will be equal to 80H, it will be equal to 81H, it will be equal to 82H, it will be equal to 83H, right? And as we know, when 00, it will be the address of port A, when 01, it will be the address of port B, when 10, it will be address of port C, and when 11, it will be the address of CWR. Right? So this way we can interface our 8255 with 8085 in IO mapped IO. Right? Now, if it happens to be memory mapped IO, if it happens to be memory mapped IO, then the remaining address lines, that means A0 to A7 we are getting here, and the dedicated address lines, that is A8 to A15, they will come out into the picture. Now, along with this remaining 6 lines from here and these 8 lines here, then we will decode all these 8 lines, 8 plus 6 8 lines, that is, all together we will decode all the other lines, you can say the remaining that is A2 से लेकर के A15 तक की सभी address lines को हम remaining address lines को we will decode and on the basis of that we will generate the addresses here. For example, अगर हम यही लेते हैं, यही combination लेते हैं, that means exact same, then what will be the values here? The values will be A2 से लेकर के A15 तक की value क्या हुई? That is 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, then 4 0 0 0 0 0 4 0s, then 0 1, then 1 1 1 1 1 1. This combination will produce a 0 here, and along with this, if we add on the A1 and A0, A1 and A0 line, they can be 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, and hence what will be the addresses? Then the address will be F8 3C, that is F8 3C F8 3D F8 3E, and F83F will be the address of the port A, port B, port C and CWR respectively. And instead of connecting this to this one, IO read bar and IO write bar, then we will connect these signals, read and write signal, to the memory read and the memory write signals. Then we will say that it is interfaced in memory mapped IO. The only difference between IO mapped IO and memory mapped IO is these signals and the number of address lines. They are to be in IO mapped IO, only these lines are to be decoded, and in case of memory mapped IO, along with this, these lines, they are also to be decoded through any type of multiplexer, ho sakta, decoder ho sakta, kuch bhi ho sakta, is tarike se hum uska use kar sakte hain. That will be the address of this one. So it is interfacing of 8255 with 8085 in IO mapped IO and in memory mapped IO. Right? Now, in case of interfacing of 8255 with 8086, in case of 8086, suppose this is my 8086 chip, microprocessor 8086. Now, जैसे कि हमने IO input output devices interface किए थे, keyboard and ये थे IO interfacing के time 8086 के साथ, उस time वहाँ पर हमने discuss किया था कि भी 8086 के साथ जो IO device है, input output device है, वे even port और odd port के तौर पर interface होती है. That means जो हमारी यहाँ पर 16 data lines है, उन 16 data lines के साथ interface करने के लिए अगर हम 8255 को interface करते हैं, 8255 जिसमें कि सिर्फ 8 ही data line है, it means there will be two separate 8255, right? There must be two separate 8255. That is, you can say this will be 18255, this will be 18255, and this will be another 8255. दो 8255 एक साथ इसके साथ इंटरफेस होंगी, हो सकती है. अगर हमें एक की जरूरत है तो हम एक ही इंटरफेस करेंगे, पर दो हो सकती है क्योंकि 8086 के साथ 16 डाटा लाइन है, जबकि यहां पर इसके पास 8 डाटा लाइन है D0 to D7. इसके पास 8 डाटा लाइन है D0 to D7. As far as this side is concerned, that is again the same, port A, port B, port C. Port A, port B and port C, right? Or is on this side, again, we will interface the IO devices. So we are not talking about this, that we will discuss while we are interfacing some specific examples, right? So here it is D0 to D7, it is D0 to D7. Here it is A1 and A0, A1 and A0. Here it is A1 and A0. Same. Here it is RD bar. And here it is WR bar. Right? Then you can say reset. मैं रीसेट को यहां लिखने की बजाय आई कैन यूज द रीसेट इधर की बजाय. चलो रीसेट, हियर इट इज रीसेट, हियर इट इज रीसेट, here it is RD bar, here it is WR bar, and this we will take as chip select signal. Iska reset bhi main upar hi le leta hun. The reset of it is also upstairs. Up. Ye iska reset ho gaya. Theek hai? This is, and this is chip select of this one, and this is the chip select of this one, CS bar, and this is CS bar, right? Now these signals, they are to be interfaced with 8086. 8086, which is having this latch IC. Kitni latch IC? 3 numbers of latch IC, 8282. क्योंकि किस किन को वो करना है इसने? It will demultiplex AD0 to AD7 and A16/S3 से लेकर के A19/S6 and also BHE bar/S7. So these all signals, they are to be demultiplexed by these three latches available here, and it is latch enable, and this latch enable is connected to the ALE signal of 8086. Here we are using 8086 in minimum mode, right? From here comes over trans receivers, receiver that is 8286, and to this trans receiver, the input is DT/R bar and DEN bar, and from here we will get the demultiplexed D0 to D7 and D8 to D15 address data lines, whereas from here we will get the A0 to A19 address lines, right? And from here we will get then RD bar, WR bar, IO bar / M, and we will have control signal generator,
which may be a decoder, may be a decoder, right? And from here we will get over 4 control signal, IO R bar, IO W bar, MEM R bar and MEM W R bar, right? So we get all the signals which are to be connected here except the reset. In 8086, the reset signal is generated by the clock generator. So there will be a clock generator here, there will be a clock generator here, clock generator, which is 8284, right? This clock generator will get the reset signal, output from the reset signal. Okay. Now the D0 to D7 lines from here, they are to be connected to the these data lines. D0 to D7, the lower bus, data bus, is connected to the lower bank or the even bank of the bus system of the IO port. So now it becomes even port, whereas the higher bus, that is D8 to D15, they are to be connected to the odd port. So now it becomes odd port. When we have this even port and odd port, then it is that the even port, that is enabled, that is chip selected by the A0, by A0 will be used to enable this chip, and BHE bar will be enabled the odd port. BHE bar will enable the odd port. So there will be two ports, one is enabled by A0, another is enabled by BHE bar. Right? Now A1 and A0, A1 and A0 address lines, okay? These are to be connected to the address lines from here. Now from here, A0 address lines, that is connected here. So A0 will now not be connected here. Here the signal which are to be connected, they are A1 here and A2 here. A1 here and A2 here. Because A0 is never used in 8086, A0 is never used for address purposes. It is always used to enable the even port in IO interfacing, or even bank, memory bank in case of memory interfacing. So we are left with A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, etc. Right? Now, as far as RD bar and WR bar is concerned, depending on whether this is interfaced in IO mapped IO or in memory mapped IO, they are to be connected. If it is in IO mapped IO, that means this IOR bar will be connected to RD here, this will be connected to the RD here, and this IOW bar, this IOW bar is to be connected to the WR bar of this and WR bar of this, right? Depending on whether they are in memory mapped IO or in IO mapped IO, these two signals, they are interfaced with this one. Now we are left with the chip select signal. This chip select signals, they are the remaining address line. In case of IO mapped IO, in case of IO mapped IO, I am talking about IO mapped IO. So the address can be of 8 bit, the address can be of 16 bit in case of 8086 in IO mapped IO. If the address is of 8 bit, then hum abhi tak hum NAND gate leke chal rahe the, ab hum ek bar decoder bhi lekar ke ye kaam kar sakte hain. That means suppose maine ek decoder liya, I took this decoder. ये 2 to the 4 हो सकता, 3 is to 8 हो सकता, कुछ भी हो सकता. Suppose I took a 3 is to 8 decoder or 4 is to... So here, A3, A4, A5. 3 is to 8 decoder में, अगर हम 74138 की बात करें, 74138 की बात करें, तो 74138 में तीन कंट्रोल सिग्नल, तीन चिप सेलेक्ट सिग्नल होते हैं. तीन कौन से? एक हाई और दो लो. दैट मींस तीन चिप सेलेक्ट सिग्नल हुए, एक हाई और दो एक्टिव लो. तो 3, 4, 5 यहां लगा रहे, 7, 6 and 7 बच गए. सपोज मैंने A7 यहां लगा दिया एंड इन दोनों को क्लब करके A6 यहां लगा दिया. आई कैन डू एनी परम्यूटेशन कॉम्बिनेशन फॉर दिस एंड इन रिस्पॉन्स वी विल गेट 8 आउटपुट्स. जीरो, वन, टू, थ्री, फोर, फाइव, सिक्स, सेवन. एंड इनमें से ये एक कंट्रोल सिग्नल, ये एक चिप सेलेक्ट सिग्नल मैंने ले लिया. सपोज दिस वन. नाउ दिस चिप सेलेक्ट सिग्नल विल बी यूज टू अनेबल दिस चिप एज वेल अनेबल दिस चिप, राइट? This way. So this way, these two they will be interfaced. If we decode the addresses, then what will be the addresses? If we decode the address range here, we can do that. Right? Now, A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7. ठीक है? So, when this decoder will be enabled, when A7 is 1 and A6 will be 0. That means A7 is 1, A6 is 0, then and then only this decoder will be enabled. And 4 is 0 here, 4 is 0 here, the input combination, that means A5, 4, 3, they must be 010, 010. This is the decoder enable and decoder input, right? A2 and A, they must be 00 for port A. They must be 01 for port B. They must be 10 for port C. And they must be 11 for CWR, right? And this 0, A0, can be 0, can be 1, 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 right? So on the basis of this, we will have this 9 and 00. If we take it as 0, so it will be 9, and if we take this 0, so 90H if it is taking 91, so 91H, then if we take, this will be the addresses for port A, and similarly this along with, if we take 0 this, that means 92 and 93, then similarly 94, 95, then similarly 96 and 97. This will be the address of port A, this will be the address of port B, this will be the address of port C, this will be the address of CWR. That means A will be 0 for this one, A 0 will be equal to 0 for this chip, and A 0 is equal to 1 for this chip. Right? Iska matlab kya hua? It means this one, this one, this one, this one will be the addresses of port A, port B, port C and CWR of the old port, whereas this one, this one, this one, this one will be the address of port, even port of A to of this even port, where A value A0 is 0. So port, ek port yahan ka hoga, dusra port A yahan se hoga. 8 bit yahan jayenge is address ke saath, aur 8 bit yahan jayenge it is address ke saath. Similarly port B yahan se hoga aur port B yahan se hoga. 8 bit yahan jayenge ya aayenge is address ke saath, 8 bit yahan aaye jayenge is address ke saath, and so on. Is it right? So it is IO mapped IO with 8 bit address. This address can be of 16 bit. The address can be of 16 bit. In that case, we have to decode the remaining A8 to A15 lines also with the help of this decoder only. That means I can use a NAND gate to enable this chip. I can use this, enable this chip. So there will be a various permutation combination for that. That means 8 bit ke address ki bajaye, now I can use, I have to use 16 bit address for the two chips. 16 bit ka address hoga. Similarly for memory mapped IO, wahi changes hoge, yahan 16 ki bajaye 20 bit ka address hame yahan par decode karna padega is circuitry ke jariye, aur usko humne yahan par aur yahan par A0 ke through aur BHE bar ke through hote hue isko interface karna, in do ports ko enable karne ke liye, even port or odd port ko enable karne ke liye. Ek port se 8 bit ka data milega, dusre port se remaining 8 bit ka data milega, agar hame 16 bit ka data use karna hai to. Aur yahan se memory read aur memory write, jo do control signal hai, these memory read and memory write, they will be connected to the read and write control signal of this two IO ports. So this is interfacing of 8255 with 85 as well as with 86. 86 mein interface karte time ye baat yaad rakhne ki hai ki do port ho sakte hain, but it is not mandatory. Agar humne ek hi 8 bit ke port se hi kaam, hamara kaam chal ja raha hai, to hum ek hi 8 bit ka port laga lenge, ya to ye laga lenge ya ye laga lenge. कोई ये जरूरी मैंडेटरी नहीं है कि ये दोनों साइमल्टेनियसली हमेशा एग्जिस्ट करें. अगर हमारे जो आईओ डिवाइसेस जो यहाँ इंटरफेस कर रहे हैं, वो इंटरफेसिंग डिवाइसेस जो है 16 बिट के हैं, तो हम दो आईओ पोर्ट्स को इंटरफेस करेंगे, इवन एन ओड पोर्ट को. पर अगर मान लीजिए हम, वो हमें 8 ही बिट का पोर्ट है, तो वो 8 बिट का पोर्ट हम इसके थ्रू कर सकते हैं, इसके थ्रू कर सकते हैं, कोसी एक के थ्रू कर सकते हैं, तो उस केस में दूसरे वाला सर्किट एज इट इज खत्म हो जाएगा. अगर इसको खत्म कर रहे हैं तो इसका मतलब है हम इवन पोर्ट के थ्रू उनको ऐड इंटरफेस कर रहे हैं, अगर इसको यूज कर रहे हैं तो इसका मतलब हम ओड पोर्ट के थ्रू उसको इंटरफेस कर रहे हैं। सिर्फ एड्रेसेस की ये हमें ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा, ये इवन एड्रेस यूज करेंगे अगर ये आईओ पोर्ट यूज कर रहे हैं, ये एड्रेस यूज करेंगे अगर ये वाला यूज कर रहे हैं तो। ठीक है, डिपेंडिंग ऑन आईओ मैप्ड आईओ और मेमोरी मैप्ड आईओ, दिस विल बी द इंटरफेसिंग एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट ओनली वी विल यूज इन द प्रोग्रामिंग, वी विल यूज द आईओ रिलेटेड इंस्ट्रक्शंस और द मेमोरी रिलेटेड इंस्ट्रक्शंस, राइट। सो दिस इज आईओ इंटरफेसिंग ऑफ 8255 विद 86 इन आईओ मैप्ड आईओ एंड इन मेमोरी मैप्ड आईओ विद 8-bit एड्रेस, विद 16-bit एड्रेस एंड विद 20-bit एड्रेस। ओके, इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल टेक अप सम एग्जांपल्स। थैंक यू।